She blazed a trail in television and for women everywhere, and today we're getting the sad news that actress and producer Mary Tyler Moore has died at the age of 80. She battled diabetes for many years and even underwent brain surgery in 2011.
Who can turn the world on with her smile? Who can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile? Well, it's you, girl, and you should...
The Mary Tyler Moore Show, about a single woman trying to make it in a TV newsroom in the 70s, was pioneering for its time. If you don't know Mary Tyler Moore, but you're a fan of Liz Lemon or Murphy Brown or Ally McBeal or Carrie Bradshaw, then really, in many ways, you have Mary Richards to thank, a woman that turned the world on with her smile and set an example for a generation of women.
The station manager ought to trust my judgment. I mean, I am the associate producer on the show.
The seven-time Emmy winner not only made it after all, but in spite of it all, blazing trails as a TV producer and executive. Along with her second husband, Moore founded MTM Enterprises, the company behind such legendary hits as Hill Street Blues and Newhart and Rhoda.
Mountain greenery, ooh, what scenery. In our mountain greenery, we're God place scenery. Just two crazy people together. Always together.
But it was this first starring role in 1961 when a young Mary Tyler Moore played the headstrong wife of Dick Van Dyke in the namesake hit show that really had Americans taking notice. Off screen, she would fill the role of loving wife three times. Her third husband was by her side as she passed. The two had been married since 1983.
I think we all need some Kleenex.
There's some on Mary's desk.
And just as in that famous final scene of the Mary Tyler Moore Show, when the WJM news crew moves in a group hug to grab the tissue, so many fans and loved ones having some trouble letting go of the beloved actress today. Let's bring in James Lipton, the host of Inside the Actors Studio. Welcome back to the show, James. Despite the sad circumstances, you've gotten to know her well over the years. What was the most striking thing about her to you?
The most striking thing about Mary Tyler Moore is one word. One word. I'll bet everybody who's listening at this moment knows what that word is, and that was her smile. That smile was radiant, unforgettable. And when we think of Mary Tyler Moore, we think of a brave and feisty and extraordinary woman smiling through.
I'll be honest, that was exactly the word I thought you were going to say.
Sure.
Yeah, she's most known, of course, for the Mary Tyler Moore Show, and this notion of an unmarried career woman seems obviously very normal now, but back in the 70s, how groundbreaking was that role?
It was revolutionary. Women didn't do that in those days, and she did. And the result was that she not only changed television, but she changed the life around her. And she changed the lives of countless women. That's a great contribution to have made.
And she obviously had quite an impact off the screen. She was a passionate advocate for diabetes research.
The amazing thing was she was on my show in 1999. And we talked about it then. And look how long she fought it before she finally was conquered by it. But I remember at that time how valiant she seemed. And here's another thing about Mary Tyler Moore. Mary Tyler Moore lived closer to death and to illness than the rest of us do in the course of her lifetime. It was always there. Of course, she lost a son to a gunshot wound. It was always there, always present. And she knew always that eventually her condition would deteriorate, as it does with people who have diabetes 1. And yet she was able to continue to work. Look what she did in Ordinary People. Or perhaps the most remarkable thing she ever did was Ordinary People, where she completely shifted gears when she played a woman who was grieving the drowning death of one of her sons and the attempted suicide of another. This was a highly dramatic role for which she received an Emmy nomination, excuse me, an Oscar nomination. And it was a complete shift of gears for her. She was able to go from the Mary Tyler Moore show where she threw her hat in the air, remember? All of us remember that moment when the hat froze in the air. What joy that was. Joy for her. Joy for us. And at the same time, she was able to shift gears to do a film like Ordinary People, where she was as good an actor as anybody we've seen on the screen in that period.
Really? It's in the same way that Shonda Rhimes, the executive producer of Grey's Anatomy, talks about how she meets people who went into medicine because of when they were young girls, they were watching Grey's Anatomy that's now been on television, I think, 10 years. I know there's a whole generation of women reporters who were truly inspired by Mary Tyler Moore in that show. Did she realize her impact both on women journalists, but also just on women and everyone, really?
I think she knew it. Look, Valerie Harper spun off from her, Cloris Leachman spun off from her, Lou Grant, the character Lou Grant played by Ed Asner, Asner spun off from her. She and her husband, Grant Tinker, at that time, they created one incredible show after another, all of them inspired by and launched by her show, about by the Mary Tyler Moore show. That's an extraordinary achievement. She not only changed her life, she changed a lot of lives. She was a life changer. And she did so in the face of very, very daunting odds. I don't know of anyone who would have, I think, faced the number of difficulties that she faced and the risks that she took as gallantly and as joyfully and as sweetly and, here's another word, charmingly as she did. She gave us a great, great gift. None of us will ever forget her, but we will also be influenced by her forever because she changed so many lives and so many American myths and customs during her lifetime and her work. She simply made us look at the world differently, and once we did, we never went back.
I know you knew her off camera as well as on camera. Do you have a favorite clip or personal memory of her you want to share before we bid adieu to you, James?
Well, I don't have here. I'm at home today, and I don't have the show, and I don't remember what she said when I asked her, what would you like to hear God say when you arrive at the pearly gates, but I suspect it would be very meaningful at this moment. I don't know whether you have it, but if you do, for heaven's sake, play it, please.
We don't have that clip ready. I'm sorry about that, but James Lipton, thank you so much. It's always charming to talk to you, and we really appreciate it.